But he follows the same process, so he still has his lifeline attached, so he's not going to go anywhere that way. He's going to throw his claw over to the next tree, and it's a pretty simple theory. He still has his lifeline attached, but the more pressure or tension he puts on his claw line, the less he puts on his lifeline, he'll just swing right over.
32 tall!
32.
Yeah.
So what he does?
Do a lot quicker, right?
That'll work, eh?
Yeah.
I watch this guy work on the show. They work on the show and it's a palm bag. Beautiful wrench. They're quite close. And this guy's working. He's doing that. And a lot of it was cleaned at the bottom, so they had some of the branches. Oh my God. I wouldn't believe this guy.
I'm gonna get tired of watching that.
Want to find a tree to climb now, Jim? Or wait?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hey, clog shot.
Once he gets there, then basically he just puts his scare strap around, which is his steel core, and he undoes the taut line and pulls it back to himself, and then continues on up that tree. For this instance, he would have been just faster coming to the ground again, but a lot of cases, if we get in nicer wood with some cleaner tops, we can really pick up a lot of efficiency there.
Oh. now that we've cut some of these pines too, I bet you we could leave some more hinge wood on these. They break off real nice.
Water truck to service.
But yeah, I'm sure they'd still break off with another quarter of an inch. I believe that first incense seed we pulled off was 8,000 pounds.
They don't want to put a cut. If you're gonna do it like this and bring it into the land, and you got the tree the best you can do, then you work from there.
Yeah.
Right there.
Oh, okay, I see.
And it came all over here.
Yeah, when we digged it, we came too far on it.
Hey, that's not a bad incense cedar. I'm surprised how good that one is.
This is your first
one. Probably the best one I've seen around here.
Typically, because the key of it too is to have it off. So you can visualize that straight line. By coming a little further, shot in the middle, and it breaks that seam too, so if you do want to get splinters coming up, it kind of breaks it where it reduces them down.
What'd you say happened on this one?
This one here, just the weakness in the wood, and did come back far. Sometimes, most of the time, it doesn't happen, but odds are it will happen.
What was coming in on the landing yesterday or the day before?
That's what he's talking about, is we're talking about the butt's lighter than the top in all of these. So like if you were just bucking off a log here, you'd find the weight per board foot of this bottom stuff would be a lot lighter than what your top would be. And so trying to define, okay, how fast does it go up, and then what is the average in the tree? It's figuring out where it's at. In a lot of cases, we'd log conventionally before, so we got a feel for what our weights are going to be. So you can pretty much start to put some numbers to it.
The tanks are actually...